It's time for the Family Feud, introducing the Martell family. Joan, Michelle, Charlie, Louise, and Gretchen, ready for action. And the Blair family. Phil, Phil Sr., Mary Jo, Jeff, and Mike. On your marks. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dalton.
Thank you. We're all cutie pies. We're delighted you're all here. The champs of the Martell.
All right.
How you doing, darling?
Yes.
How much money did you win the day you became the champ?
$5,321.
Let me meet everybody, please.
Pardon me?
Let me meet everybody,
please. All right, Richard. This is my family. My daughter, Michelle.
Hello, Richard.
Hello, Michelle.
My son, Charles.
Charles.
Hello, Richard.
And my daughter, Louise.
Hi, Richard.
Hi, darling.
And my daughter, Gretchen.
Sweet Gretchen.
Hi.
Welcome. Family build a boat, and there's 33 feet?
33 foot overall.
Called the Nebula?
The Nebula, right.
And we're going to give them a bottle of champagne when they launch it.
Okay, and, I'll let you know when that's going to be.
I promise you, I'll get it up here. I'm going to talk to Michelle. She's obviously an Elvis Presley.
Brought them in the Blair.
How you doing? I thought it was a live bird for a moment.
It's not real, Richard.
My heart stopped for a second. I thought I saw a live bird here. Let's meet everybody, please.
Richard, I'd like to introduce you to my father. His name is Phil also.
How are you there,
Phil?
Hi,
Richard.
Good to see you, sir.
And my mother, Mary Jo.
Hi,
Mary
Richard.
Jo, pretty lady.
My brother, Jeff.
Hi, Richard.
And Jeff there.
And my littlest brother, Mike.
Hey, Michael.
Hi.
Good to have you there.
And we have a gift for you, Richard.
Okay. Now, this, well, Joe, I just want to explain one thing that I cannot believe this gentleman has done. Are you an alderman?
I'm an alderman in the city of Madison. That's correct.
All right.
Richard.
Now, he was going to run again for that office, same office or different office?
Same office.
But we can't have candidates, you know, once they file to get on, we can't have people do that because of the, what was that, the fairness doctrine. We'd have to have everybody who was going to run for the office on, which wouldn't be a bad idea. It'd be a cheap way to get a people from Madison. But so now we explain this to this young man, and he's decided he's not going to run. I swear to you, I did not think that you would do that, but I'm delighted you made the decision.
We're happy to be here.
And congratulations. Man's thrown away a career. Let me meet the duck here.
Sure.
What is this, Phil?
I'd like to give this gift. My hobby is wood carving. Wisconsin has a lot of ducks, so I thought we'd make one of these for you.
This? God, you must look at, I cannot believe it. I swear to you, I thank you and I'll treasure it. And I might run for office, won't you? Come, we'll play the feud. There he is. He's pretty neat, isn't he? 100 people surveyed, top 6 answers on the board. You got to try and get the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name something a nurse brings with her during her daily rounds. Phil.
Temperature thing.
A temperature thing. A good, fine, lawyer mind. I know what he means. I know what he means.
He's not running for office.
Just do us a favor. Don't defend anyone who has a capital rap against them. A temperature thing.
We'll play, Richard.
All right, we're going to play.
Okay.
Temperature thing. What's the nurse going to bring with her, Phil, Senior?
How about a bedpan, Richard?
Very well, sir, a bedpan. No, not that. Well, they do bring them. I don't know if they always travel.
Hello, Richard.
Nice to have you here. Got a nurse going on her daily rounds. What might she bring with her?
Pills.
Good answer.
Yeah. Pills? Yeah. All done, Mary Jo. Jeff. How are you? Welcome. Good to have you with us, Jeff.
Nice to be here.
What do you say?
I will say a stethoscope.
Hey, that's
a good one.
It is kind of hard. Stethoscope. Yeah. Well done. Thank you. What? How you doing there, Mike?
Fine.
How old are you, young man?
13.
You're a very snazzy-looking young man. Something a nurse brings with her during her daily round.
A doctor?
Is there a doctor in the house? No! I like his line of thought. Well?
I'd say the chart.
Yeah.
Okay, good answer.
That's to see how you're going, right? Is there all right, if not third strike? Chart? You got it. Well, you're better with just one word at a time. You're absolutely right. Bill.
An instrument to check the blood pressure.
Another
good one.
Unless they're okay, if not, there's not. Blood pressure checker.
Oh, yeah.
One more. Pretty mama. Well?
Well, how about a tray of food?
A tray of food.
Oh, good.
Unless they're all right, if not, third strike. Food, a tray. Nope. $95 up there. Come on, Joan.
Watch, Mom.
A watch.
Oh, I love to watch.
Oh, a watch?
Fine. Is it from being there? Peter Sellers. If a watch is there, you get the $95. If not, Phil and Phil got it. Watch! $95 there, nothing there. Big Phil, let's go. Come on. Graceland.
Oh, thanks.
Graceland, here we come.
Okay.
100 people surveyed, top 7 answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something people try to stifle. Yes, dear?
Their cough.
Ah, their cough.
All right.
Well done. 3 answers will beat that, Phil.
Wow. A fire.
A fire. No.
You wanna
play? Gonna,
play
or pass? Do you guys want to
play?
We're gonna play.
Very, very good. Very proud. Charles!
Yes, Richard.
Good to see you. Something people try to stifle.
Something you're trying to do. Other people.
That's a good answer.
Stifle
yeah.
other people.
Yeah.
She's an Archie Bunker fan. Go stifle yourself, it's a... Other people! Well done. Hi, my lover.
I would say a sneeze.
Yeah!
Very good, yeah. Sneeze! Excellent.
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
Sorry to hear that.
I'm gonna try to think along the same lines and say a yawn.
Pretty. I like that. We'd love one stifled yawn to go, please. $78, 3 answers left, and no strikes.
Well, if you were gonna fall and you kinda, I don't know. That would be to stop it.
Explain to me what you mean.
Well, if you're gonna go to fall and you kinda grab yourself so that you don't, you kinda
you stifle
stop.
Your fall?
Well, that's not really the right word, but I guess maybe
yeah.
I'd use it
I mean,
here.
If you were...
Yeah,
like
I would, yes,
coming
I
down
would.
Some steps, you would stifle a fall?
Yeah!
To avoid it, let's look. Pride goes before a stifle. No.
Oh.
It's better than not saying anything. We've had
yeah.
answers up there and...
Yes.
Okay, well, I think sometimes I see people in restaurants try to stifle their cigarette smoke.
Okay.
Stifle cigarette smoke.
Okay. All right.
Right?
That's
right.
it, Michelle.
Guard.
Well, you know.
Cigarette smoke.
Oh,
no.
Wow.
Charles. Something that people try to stifle.
Their vocabulary, choice of a dirty word or something like that.
No, okay.
From the film, watch your language. If it's there, all right. If not, third strike. Their language.
Oh!
$78 up there.
Okay.
Come on there, Phil.
Conversation. Laugh.
Something people try to stifle.
Their laugh, Richard.
Their laugh.
Good answer.
If it laughs now, you get it. Very even game. If not, a big lead for Joan and the family. Ha, 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 ha. Five. Seven. We mustn't do that because medically it's dangerous. Turns into a game we've got going here. We got 95 there and 78 there. Am I big 70? Let's go. There's your child. First family to get to 300 will play for $5,000. 100 people surveyed, top five answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a nut you would use in a candy recipe.
Walnut.
Play or pass?
Play. They want to play.
I'll be right back. Don't worry. Not at all. I'm proud of you. Gave me number one answer.
I think I would use an almond.
Almond, yeah.
Put in.
All right. Yeah. Jeff Almond.
Great.
Pecan.
Good lad. Pecan. Yeah. Now you can eat your candy.
Good. Very good.
I'm very proud of him. Phil?
Yes, sir.
Well, nut would you use?
Peanut.
Peanut. You got it. Big Phil.
I love cashews.
You do? Oh,
yeah.
I was going to say bless you, but we won't reach for that. Cashew? $177.95.
Let's go. Oh,
sorry. It's all right.
100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Besides their spouses, name someone for whom men buy flowers. Yes.
Their mothers.
Ah. Flowers for you, Mom. Very sweet answer. Not only number one, a nice thought. Besides spouses, who do men buy flowers for?
They're secretaries.
Uh-huh. Right. Secretary. Right. Joan?
A girlfriend.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
I'm sorry to say that occurs occasionally. A girlfriend. Besides their spouses, someone for whom men buy flowers.
Well, some nice son-in-laws buy them for their mother-in-laws.
Okay. Right. If that's it, you got it all. For your mother-in-law?
Oh.
No. Honey, that was a good answer, though. It didn't make our survey. What do you say, Charles?
Yeah, can I just...
This should not come as a surprise. Yeah,
well,
has it, Charles?
Well, I'm a man, and I don't have a spouse, so I've got to buy my own flowers for my house, so...
For someone who men buy flowers, you'd buy them for yourself?
Sure. No one else buys them for me.
Well, you give me a call.
I'll get them now.
Give me a call because I have five dead carnations at the end of the week. Well, we'll send them straight to your house. For himself. No. Come on, darling, now. We need a correct answer because otherwise they can steal and become the champs.
Okay.
Besides spouses, someone for whom men buy flowers.
If they were a sweet dad, they'd buy them for their daughter.
That's lovely.
Yeah. Oh, yeah!
If that's there, my love, you got it all. And if not, third strike for their daughter.
All right!
$289, $177. This is gonna do it. Let's go. That's in the mic. There you go. The dollar values are tripled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something kids take to school with them.
Books.
Books. One answer will beat that.
Paper?
Paper?
No.
We're gonna play.
They're gonna play.
All right.
Listen carefully. I will not repeat this question. When I get to you, you got 3 seconds to answer it. It's not hard at all. Name something kids take to school with them. June.
Maybe a gift for their teacher the first day.
Gift? Okay. No. Oh. Michelle, 3 seconds.
Okay. I'm going to say they take their homework.
Homework?
Yeah, homework.
Oh. Charles, 3 seconds.
Lunch.
Lunch!
All right.
Three seconds.
Okay, I'd say they take money for milk.
Okay. What?
There we go.
Money!
All right!
I'm so excited I have one. They gotta get to school on their bicycle.
Okay.
If bike's there, you keep your title. If not, third strike. Their bike! No. Give me the correct answer. You'll play for $5,000.
Give me one.
Buzzer when I need an answer.
Pencils.
Pencils. If it's there, you're the champs. If not, you keep your title. Pencil. $289 plus $5,321. You're beautiful. You got champagne for your boat. My bonus. The day you launch the boat. I send you champagne. Go play. One. Come on, who's first? Jeff and Bill going for the money right after we watch this. You did it, Jim.
If your family like to have a good time, why don't you try to become a contestant?
Please give Jeff 15 seconds. Tell me a man's first name that begins with the letter J.
Jeff.
A spring flower.
Rose.
How much cash do you carry around with you?
$20.
A magazine with a one-word name.
Time.
A sport played indoors.
Hockey.
All righty.
That's nerve-wracking.
Yeah.
I made it.
Oh, it is. The first time you get up there, it's kind of scary. You just said it's nerve-wracking. You've done it now, though. Yeah. And you're the champs, and you're going to play again. A man's first name begins with letter J. And right away, he looked at his sign. He said, Jeff!
Jeff. Not Jack.
Okay. Are we going to put in Jeff's score?
We have the score for Jeff is in there, yes.
Oh, good. If Jeff were up there, this is what the score would be. Chillis, 2. Spring flower. You said a rose. Survey said 12.
Okay.
How much cash you carry around with you? You said $20. Survey. There you go. Magazine, one word name. He said time. Survey. Now you're cooking. Sport played indoors. Hockey. Survey said 3. 82. It can be done. Go stand right next to Pop. All right. We're looking for Phil.
How many
did
you get?
82? 82, and you can do it this very easily. I want 118 out of you, okay? Gonna do it?
We'll get it.
Fine. Give us 20 seconds on that temperature, and remind everybody what Jack told us. Here we go. Tell me a man's first name that begins with the letter J.
Jeff.
Try again.
John.
A spring flower.
Daisy.
How much cash you carry around with you?
$20. $30.
A magazine with a one-word name.
Time. Life.
A sport played indoors.
Basketball.
You're a good player. You're a good player. There we go. Yeah.
Wouldn't you know it, Jeff?
Here we go. First name, Jay. You said John. It was number one.
Yay!
Somebody said? $30. Spring flower, tulip was the number one. You said a daisy. Survey said. How much cash do you carry around with you? $20, number one answer. You said 30. Survey said. 6. Magazine with a one word name. Time, number one. You said life. Survey said. 14. Sport played indoors. You said basketball. It was number one. If it's worth 41 points, you got the money. Survey said.
$1.99, $5 every point total of $9.95.
Family, the Martells, when they're going to christen their boat. The next time. Next time, I'm going to take young Mike's advice and ask mention a Cadillac. He's going now. He's going now. We'll see you here on The Feud. Bye-bye.
Some of the parting contestants receive a Mark Goodson television production. Family Feud, introducing the Blair family. Bill, Phil Sr., Mary Jo, Jeff and Mike, ready for action. And the Ryerson family. Jerry, Nancy, Dana, Ken, and Susie, on your marks. Let's start The Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
Thank you. I had a week off and I went
from Madison to Blair.
Nice to see you again.
How much did you win? You became the champs on our last show?
Richard, we won $1,412 yesterday.
All righty, let's meet everybody.
Richard, I'd like you to meet my father, Phil Sr., my mother. Mary Jo.
Hello, my darling.
Hi, Richard.
My brother, Jeff.
Hi, Richard. Big Jeff.
And my little brother, Mike.
Hey, Michael. Now, you see Feud in Madison on what channel?
Yeah, we see it on WKOW Channel 27 in Madison, Wisconsin.
And we'd like to thank them because when we go around the country, finding families that come on, as we do, and we flew you out here, right? And we look after you.
You bet.
Yes, sir.
We always need a station in a city to help us, and Channel 27, we're champs, and we thank them very much. Okay. This young man's an alderman in his hometown, and he filed to run again, so we told him he couldn't be on because of the fairness doctrine. He said, to heck with it, I'll come on The Feud and I'll run next year. And he became the champs. Congratulations.
Thank you, Richard, very much.
Really good to have you here.
We're happy to be here.
Ryersons are here to challenge you. Let's make them feel at home.
How are you?
Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Let me meet everybody, sir.
Yes, Richard, this is my wife, Nancy.
Hey,
darling. Wife of 12 years.
Nice to see you.
The magician of the family.
Aha.
Dana.
I love magicians.
Hi, Richard.
Dana.
Okay, and my little baby brother there, Kenny.
Hi, Ken.
How are you doing, Richard?
Okay, and my lovely sister-in-law, Susie.
Sweet.
Hi,
Susie. Welcome. I love magic. Can you do something for me?
Sure.
I love magicians. Excuse me a second.
Oh, I see something? How you doing?
Sure. How long have you been doing magic?
Since I was 11 years old. So that's, I'm in 22 now. So that's why. Yeah.
Just do a trick.
Do it. What are you? It's playing cards, but.
Playing cards?
Anyways. I have a little coin trick here.
Oh,
this is called the coin roll. I got pulled over one time for a sobriety test, and the officer said, "Can you do this?" And I said, "Can you do that?" And anyways, gave the coin a little blow like that, and it disappears. Just in it.
Pretty good.
So you bring it back the same way. Close your hand.
Yeah.
Give it a little wave, and go watch. 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 One, two, three, and the coin comes right back.
All right.
All right. Can I look at that coin? That's a regular coin. I thought maybe it was like a rubber one or something. That. just a second.
Yeah!
One more. You got one more trick?
Also, Richard, well, I have here, I'm a member of the Magic Castle in Hollywood.
Yeah, that's where all the magicians go and entertain and work out tricks and impress each other. So he's obviously good. If you're
right.
The...
And this is a pass to the Magic Castle, and this is in your name, and you can
now,
go
can
there
I
anytime.
No, but can I be there when you're there? Would you let me know when you're going to be there?
Sure.
Because
yes.
I'd like to see your act. Oh, you're a very talented young man.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right.
Get your playing cards out.
Come, we'll play the feud. Let's go.
All right.
People surveyed, top five answers on the board. You got to try and get the most popular answer. Now, for this question, we asked 100 men, no women. Here's the question we asked them. We said, what do you spend most of your time thinking about? Phil.
Women.
Women.
Yeah. Are you going to play or can?
We will play.
Okay, fine.
All right.
That being the number one answer, it's just as well you're not running for alderman again. Big Phil, how you doing?
Just fine, Richard, thank you.
This man is a wood carver, and you did me a duck. I wish I'd brought it to show you. It's absolutely marvelous. I have more comment about it today. Two people came visit me and saw. 100 men now, we asked. We said, what do you spend most of your time thinking about?
Hunting.
Hunting.
Good answer.
No hunting?
Not a good answer.
Well, I thought it would be if you were a hunter.
If you were a hunter. Hi, Richard. Good.
What do you think the men think about?
I think they think about their job.
Yeah, I do too. Job?
All right.
All right. Well?
I would say children.
Good. Oh, they think about their children, all right. Are the children there? Snazzy outfit today, Mike. You look pretty good. Get your head back, otherwise you're gonna get impaled on this microphone. How are you?
Fine.
What'd you do today?
Not much. Well, wait.
Now, wait a second.
We took a tour of Universal Studios.
Well, now, that's fun, isn't it?
Yeah.
100 men, we said. What do you spend most of your time thinking about?
Sports.
Sports! Michael, I'm going to tell you, these people lied. That's all I'm going to tell you. That was a great answer. Two strikes. What do you say there, Phil?
How about money?
Money. Money. You got it. I can't believe sports not that. Big Phil, going to finish this off for me?
How about retirement, Richard?
Retirement. All right, sir. Let's say you got it. If not, get ready to steal. Retirement. Blair's are on the board. We will return. Two for the champs, nothing for the challengers. Let's go. How are you, pretty lady? Nice to see you. Pretty lady. 100 people surveyed, top six answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something brothers borrow from their sisters. Phil.
Cosmetics.
Cosmetics. That is against the law in two states, to my knowledge.
Hair dryers.
A hair dryer. And a player pass.
We'll play, Richard.
Gonna play.
All right, yeah.
Well done.
All right.
Cosmetic. Gotta buy your own. Here's my magician friend. Something brothers borrow from their sisters.
Their car.
Yeah. Looking for a car?
All right, yeah, good one, good. Hi, Richard. How you doing?
Hi, sir. Thank you. We're looking for brothers borrowing things from their sisters.
Well, if I had a sister, I'd probably try to borrow some money.
You would?
Good answer.
Good answer. Good answer.
If I had a hammer. Money!
All right.
Hi, Richard.
Nice to have you here, Susie. What would brothers borrow from their sisters?
Well, I would have to say a hairbrush.
A hairbrush?
Good answer.
Hairbrush. Done. Up in the top. Gary?
Richard, I'm going to say, this might sound weird, clothes. Some clothes.
All right, that's good.
All right, good.
Good answer, Jerry.
Nothing gaudy, maybe a short leather skirt. Clothes? No. Right, it did sound a little weird. Pretty Nancy.
Well, how about a girlfriend?
Some things are embarrassing.
All right.
Yeah, okay. See, I wonder if you could loan me Nancy, sis. A girlfriend? No, not that. Come on now, Dana.
All right, Dana. I would say I would borrow, I have three sisters. I would borrow their school books.
Their school book.
Good answer.
Okay.
Right, good answer. Good answer.
Is there all right? If not, third's right. The school book. Oh. No.
Okay.
$78, two answers unrevealed.
Records.
Give me an answer, please.
Phonograph records.
Records.
Yeah!
And five, please. Well, the challengers at the moment are not doing too well, but I've got a feeling they're laying back. Very similar to the... 160. Nothing. Let's do it. Come on. We got to watch him because he's a magician.
I know. Oh, it's still there.
Well, no, but I've got a feeling this could be like a fake one, you know. You know how magicians are, yeah. Be looking at that and suddenly his real hand will go. All right, 100 people surveyed. Top five answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a good luck charm.
A rabbit's foot. A rabbit's foot.
A rabbit's foot. One answer will be the thing.
A four-leaf clover.
Two good answers. What are you going to do?
We're going to play it, Richard.
Well done, Dana. Do you have a good luck charm you could mention?
Yeah, I've got a few pennies in my pocket. How about a penny?
Do you
on
have
my
a penny?
Shoe? Yeah.
Well, I mean, some people carry that.
Oh, no.
He's got his good luck keys with him. We'd love a penny.
All right.
Well, thank goodness he showed up anyway.
Hi. What I think about, and it's probably off the wall, is I just keep thinking of, I tie a string around my finger when I forget things, and when I don't remember them, you know, that's not good. So
I got you.
So I have to say, like, a reminder string around your finger.
Yeah, a piece of string.
Yeah.
Well, no, but that's good.
It's good. Good.
If you tie it, do not walk off of cliff. That would be good luck because you remembered it. Not having a string, just halfway down, you say, oh, I knew there was something I... Piece of string? No. Well, Susie, I'll level with you. I wasn't too hot on the premise, but I tried to convince the people that we were going somewhere with it.
Richard, I'm thinking of some type of a bracelet or a necklace, something, a pendant around the neck. All right.
Necklace!
Oh, no. Okay.
Sweet Nancy.
What I'm thinking of is a medal, like a St. Christopher or a cross or something religious.
St. Christopher medal?
All right.
Yeah, that's great. That's a great answer.
Good answer, man. Let's go, Dana.
Come on, Dana.
Picture of your girlfriend.
All right. Good answer.
Is there all right? If not, third strike. A picture? Nope.
Horseshoe.
Richard, we're going to go with horseshoe.
A horseshoe. If it's there, you take a big lead in the game. If not, you get into the game with the $86. Horseshoe!
Yes, all right!
246 to nothing. Let's go. All right, Ken, here we go. Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something women might lie about in order to impress a date.
Yeah.
Age.
Good answer.
All right, let's go.
Well done, young man. Very good. Something women might lie about in order to impress a date.
Job?
Their job.
Good answer. Good.
Their job? Yeah! Bill? You've got 3 seconds.
How much money they make?
Let's take a look. Okay. Their income! No. Oh.
Yeah. Color of their hair.
Okay.
Their hair color. Oh. Shame on that.
How about their marital status?
Ah. Ooh. They're all right. If not, there's right. Whether they are married or not. No, not that. There are two unrevealed answers. Give me one of them. The game goes on.
Their family. Their family. Uh-huh. Family tree.
Their family.
Their background.
Oh, they're all right. Fine. Okay. That's there. All right. If not, you play for the big money one more time. Their background. Three. Four. Did anyone have weight?
I had that.
Yeah.
We had other men in dates. But,
did you really?
Yeah. That came up.
Well, I loved him. And when they won the very first question, he was beautiful. He said, yeah, way to go. What am I doing?
Yeah.
We got nothing there. I'm going to give you $50 each. You'll have $250. We got a nice prize. I'm sorry you didn't win more.
Fine. Thank you very much.
Thank you. I'm sorry. I'm going to come and see you.
Okay.
I love magic.
I'll do it. Thank you very much.
Thank you. I'm sorry you didn't win more. We'll play. One, two. Who's first? Jeff and Phil? I want to put my money here right after we watch. Win the money this time, aren't we?
Yep, we are.
Give Jeff 15 seconds, play. Tell me how many minutes per day you exercise.
30.
A food people give as a gift.
Candy.
A foreign country that sex symbols come from.
France.
Something you wax regularly.
Floor.
A job on an airplane.
Stewardess.
Turn around. How many minutes per day you exercise? You said 30. Survey said. Food people give us a gift. You said. And a survey. Foreign country sex symbols come from. La France. Survey said. And then you wax regularly. The floor. Survey said. Job on an airplane. Stewardess. Survey. Go on back there and be proud. You're looking for Phil?
Hello, Richie. What do we got? Wow!
34 points, all you need. We wish you luck. Please remind everyone the great answers Jeff gave us. Give us 20 seconds on the clock, please. Tell me how many minutes per day you exercise.
15.
A food people give as a gift.
Cheese.
A foreign country that sex symbols come from.
France.
Try again.
Sweden.
Something you wax regularly.
Floors.
Try again.
Furniture.
A job on an airplane.
Pilot.
Turn around. How many minutes per day you exercise? 30 was the number one. You said 15. Survey said. Food people give as a gift. Candy and fruit tied for top. You said cheese. You need 9 points for $5,000. Survey said. Yeah!
Wisconsin cheese, they get.
You wax your car, and a pilot was the job on an airplane. Channel 27, we thank you for sending us such nice families. We'll see you here on The Feud.
Bye-bye.
This is Gene Woods speaking for Family Feud. For Mark Goodson, television production. It's time for the Family Feud, introducing the Blair family. Phil Sr., Mary Jo, Jeff, and Mike, ready for action. And the Sierra family. Christina, Carla, Letty, Dolores, and Raquel. On your mark. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dalton.
How are you, darling?
You look gorgeous. Thank you. Thank you. Mr. Gene Wood, front, forward, please.
Yeah.
Mr. Gene Wood, my best friend, right here.
How are you? I'm terrific.
This is from all the gang here. A bottle of champagne. Happy birthday. I just found out it's your birthday. Get off. The strange thing is, last year it was in April. Madison, the champs, the Blairs.
Hello again, Richard.
How are you?
Really good.
How much money now?
$6,822.
Hey. You'll be able to buy the folks at Channel 27 a lemonade each when you get back. Let's meet everybody, please.
Like you to meet my father, Phil Sr.
Big Phil, I call him.
Hi, Richard.
Hi, Phil.
And my mother, Mary Jo.
Hello, my darling.
Hi, Richard.
My little brother, Jeff.
That's ridiculous. Hey. He's big. How are you, Jeff?
And my littler brother, Mike.
Yeah, Michael. Hey, you've got to feed some brain food, a lot of fish to Michael, because although he enjoys life and plays the game very well, he forgets the tours that he goes on.
That, yes, he does.
Yeah, make these lovely people feel at home, please. Sierra! How you doing?
Good.
You're all so beautiful.
Thank you.
Can I meet everybody, please?
Yes, this is the youngest sister of the family, Carla.
Hello, Hi, Carla. Richard.
Next in line is Letty.
Letty.
Hi, Richard.
Hi, Letty.
My oldest sister, Dolores.
Hello,
Hi, Richard.
Dolores.
And our beautiful mother, Raquel.
You're
Hello,
gorgeous.
Richard. Thank you.
Your mom's like your sister. Raquel, you're just exquisite.
Thank you.
They look like five sisters, don't they?
Thank you.
I'd like to take them all out. who's married?
Me. I am married, too. Promise.
Hold on a second. Now, two of you put your hands up, but you said, I am married.
I am.
Does this mean Dolores isn't?
Well,
I
no.
am married.
You are married. Is this just a little rivalry going
yes.
on?
No.
I've got to find out what this is about. Why would you say that? You're both lovely ladies. You have lots of rings on.
Yeah, why did you say that?
Because she's not the only one with a wonderful family.
Oh, I see.
That is fun.
Well, if I'm going to talk to someone with a wonderful family, I'm going to talk to your mom here.
Sure.
You look gorgeous.
Thank you.
Your turquoise. Elegance, huh? Gives a new meaning to the word, elegant.
Thank you.
You're beautiful. Where do you live?
In Pomona.
I'm going to move there tomorrow morning. Come, we'll play the feud. Let's go. Yeah! 100 people surveyed. Top 5 answers on the board. You got to try and get the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name something kids do for which they always seem to use the excuse, everybody else does it. Phil,
have sex.
Nice way for an alderman to talk. Every time he gets up here, that's all he ever says. Have sex! No. Your reputation's been saved again. Christina.
Stay out late at night.
Stay out late. Come on. The fire pack.
We're gonna play.
We're gonna play. Okay. All right. Very good. Now I get to meet you all. How you doing?
Hi.
Welcome to our show. Something the kids do, for which they always seem to use the excuse everybody else does it.
Smoke.
Uh-huh. They smoke! You are married?
Yes.
Okay. Well?
Well, I'm gonna say they ditch school. They don't go to class.
All righty. They ditch school. Not there. That was a good answer. Didn't make our five, that's all.
Hi.
Welcome.
Thank you. I'm gonna say drink.
Yeah, okay. Good. They booze. Oh, yeah. This is probably easy for you, isn't it, with all these children around?
Well, I think so. I'm gonna say wear makeup.
Uh-huh. Remember my younger boy? Makeup! Not that. Oh. Well, when you get a lot of pretty girls, you'll give that sort of an answer. Well, what would you think, Christine?
I think I would say, borrow the car. Borrow the car.
All right. If that's there, okay. And if not, third strike. They borrow the car. Oh. Not that. $66? Phil, Mary Jo, Jeff, Mike. Don't knock your mother over, Jeff, or I'll give you a clip around the ear.
Not doing the homework.
Not doing homework.
Don't clean their homework.
I need an answer.
Not doing their homework.
Don't yell in my ear. Just repeat it out. They don't do their homework, you get the $66. If not, Christine and ladies get it. Homework won't do it. Number three. Four. All those who cheered those last two, we want your nicks. Nothing. Let's go.
How are you doing today, big girl?
Okay. 100 people surveyed, top five answers on the board. Here's the question. There's a new generation of Kennedys growing up. Name one.
Joseph Jr.
Joseph Jr. Not there.
A John? Junior maybe.
A John? Okay.
We're gonna play.
Most tentative. A John. It worked. There's a new generation of Kennedys growing up. Name one, please.
I will say Carolyn.
Okay. Carolyn!
Bobby Jr.
Uh-huh. Bobby Jr., please.
Joan?
Pardon?
Joan?
Joan? All right. Joan! Well, no, there is a Joan, but she is grown up. Yeah, she's a grown up Kennedy. New generation of Kennedys growing up. Name one, please.
Mary.
One of my favorites. You don't read a lot about her, though, do you? She's very
shy.
Very, very quiet. Mary. No.
A Ted.
If a Ted is there, okay. If not, a third strike will appear. A Ted? My tip would be, whoever you say A in front of you. Seems to have worked here. Name a new generation of Kennedys are growing up.
A Richard.
A Richard. Scrub the A. Is there all right if not? Third strike. Ricardo. $92. Bill?
Edward.
Edward, Richard.
All right, sir. If Edward's there, you get $92. If not, big lead for the ladies. Edward? Five? Patrick. All right. Boy, they're really cooking over here. In fact, you could almost call them the highest marriage ever.
Good to see you.
Once we get that good luck fist going, we'll be on the road to recovery. 100 people surveyed, top 6 answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a flower that lots of people grow at home. Yes.
Daisies.
Daisy.
Roses.
Mary Jo said roses. Yeah. Right past.
Play.
They're gonna play.
I guess.
They're gonna play. Let's see you in a little while.
Okay.
Well done, honey. Let it be. How are you today?
Really good.
Very good. Know anything about flowers?
A little.
Give me a little flower people grow at home.
I will say tulip.
Take a look.
Okay.
Tulip. Great. There's my buddy. Different boy. Man of many changes. And you're a nifty dresser. Flower that lots of people grow at home.
Violet.
Violet. Yeah. Violet? Yeah. Are you sure?
Richard, let's try mums.
Oh, good answer.
Mum! Oh! It amazed me. That. Big man, big deal. What do you say?
Flower is a geranium.
Geranium. Oh, yeah. All right. Anyone grow geraniums at home? They did. Well done, Phil. Two of them left, and only one strike.
Oh, I have two in mine. Let's say pansies.
Pansies, yeah. Okay, madame. We'd love some pansies. Not there.
The only flower I can think of is daffodil.
Oh, good one.
Good one. A good answer. Sort of a Dutch guy, though, with flowers, isn't he? Tulips and daffodils. Daffodil there, okay. If not, third strike. Daffy! Oh, not there. $80 up there. Darlings, come down. I need an answer.
The answer is...
Quick.
Gardenias.
All right, because they buzz. Once they buzz.
Okay.
The answer is... if it's there, a big lead. If not, Phil gets into the game with the $80. Gardenia. Grace. My sweet petunia. Five. Up, Marisol. 58 plays 80. Let's go. Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top 4 answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something you do to a pack of playing cards.
Yeah. You deal them.
You deal them. Two answers will beat it.
Shuffle.
You shuffle them. Play, okay.
We're gonna play, Richard.
Very good. Very good. What a pack of playing cards. What do you do to them?
You buy them.
Very hard to shuffle
okay,
them without.
Okay,
gotta spring for them first, yeah. Buy a pack of cards. No. Oh, but it's all right. That made sense to me. Something you do to a pack of playing cards.
You play tricks. Card tricks.
Yeah.
Good card tricks.
You do tricks.
Oh!
We just had a magician on a couple of shows ago. I thought it was there.
Play poker.
Uh-huh. Okay. That's there, all right. If not, there's right. Poker! Way to do it, Don. Give me the correct answer, you'll be the champs, and you'll play for $5,000. Something you do to a pack of playing cards.
Well, I don't know if everyone does this, but when I was little, we used to build houses with the cards.
Good answer! Good answer! Good answer!
That's a great answer, Don. And if it's there, you're the champs. If not, get ready to steal them. You build houses! No! 182. I still need a correct answer.
You cut a deck of cards.
You do indeed, sir. If it's there, the game goes on. If not, you're the champs. You cut them.
All right.
262, 158. Let's go. Dollar values are tripled. This is going to decide it. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something a woman needs to make a dress. Yeah.
A sewing machine.
Sewing machine? Two answers will beat it.
Material.
Material? You got it. What are you going to do?
Brooklyn.
Okay. All right. Name something a woman needs to make a dress. Go.
Thread.
Thread! Three seconds, Phil.
Scissors!
Scissors there, you keep your title. Scissors! There you go.
A pattern.
Aha. Again, if it's there, you got it. If not, second strike. Pattern! There we got you. That was a great game. Make it $250 so you won't have lots of arguments.
Thanks.
You're gorgeous. We have nice prizes for you. And after a while, I'm sure you'd be able to go on the nighttime show because you're gorgeous.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for being in the family. Who's going to do it? Go! Yep, Bill. On for the money right after we watch this. Good to see you.
Your family like to have a good time.
Let's go for two in a row, okay? 15 seconds, please. Tell me the hour at which you wake up without an alarm clock.
8 o'clock.
A sport the family plays together.
Tennis.
Something that has a cord attached.
A lamp.
One of the seven dwarfs.
Dopey.
Something feathers are used for.
Hats.
Turn around. So I wish you wake up without an alarm clock. You said 8. Whatever you said. 24. Sport the family plays together. The board family. Tennis. Survey. 21. Something has a cord attached. A lamp. Survey said. One of the seven dwarfs, you said, Hervé? No, I'm sorry, Dopey, you said. Survey zip. And feathers are used for a hat. Survey said. Nicely done. Hey, back there at the top of me. Put them to Phil Jr.
Okay,
83 points. You get the money again. Please remind everyone the answer is Jeff Gavis. 20 seconds on the clock, please. Do-da. Tell me the hour at which you wake up without an alarm clock.
7 o'clock.
A sport the family plays together.
Baseball.
Something that has a cord attached.
Lamp.
Try again.
A hair dryer.
One of the seven dwarfs.
Sleepy.
Something feathers are used for.
Making pillows.
Turn around. The hour at which you wake up without an alarm clock. 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, they tied for the top.
Oh, good.
Survey said, Spindy Ball.
sports family play together. You said baseball. Number one answer. Survey. Oh. Something that has a cord attached. Lamp was number one. You said hair dryer. Survey said four. One of the seven dwarfs. You said
Sleepy.
He's number one. If he's worth 30, you got $5,000. Survey said. Yeah. What do you do with the feathers? Pillows. They're getting smarter by the minute. We love you. We'll see you here on The Feud.
Bye-bye.
Some departed contestants. This is Gene Wood speaking for Family Feud. I'm Mark Goodson, television producer. It's time for The Family Feud, introducing the Blair family. Phil Sr., Mary Jo, Jeff, and Mike, ready for action. And the Robinson family. Brent, Renee, Glenn, Dale, and Brent, on your mark. Let's start The Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Johnson.
Thank you. Well, they just brought out an economic study today. It's absolutely astounding. You know, to feed a family of four today, they have to eat a family of five. It's crazy, isn't it? Madison's here, the champs. They're from Blair County, Mississippi. Just saying, if you're paying attention. They brought them in from Madison. The Blairs are rolling along. How much money you got?
$12,381, Richard.
What a way to do it, champ. Meet everybody.
I'd like you to meet my father, Phil Sr.
Big Phil, I call him.
Hi, Richard.
Hi, Phil.
My mother, Mary Jo.
Hi, Richard.
Hi, darling.
My brother, Jeff.
We're getting Richard. Bigger by the moment.
And my brother, Mike.
The brains Richard. Of the group. The
brains of the family.
Right. Rascal got up in the fifth question, the last game we played. I played a lady, right? And what was it? Something, a woman needs. Make a dress. Number one answer gave me material. But if you ask him where he's been today, he has no idea. Nice big hand here for our buddies, the Robinsons.
How you doing, Richard?
I see you last night when I was leaving.
Yeah, we sure did, right in the parking lot.
I was leaving, usually the family that we always have one backup family, they always have to go home and come back normally on the first show that we tape. And I know there was a little mishap. Don't say what it is. Let's meet your family and we'll find out.
Okay, Richard, this is my wife, Renee.
Hello, my darling.
Hi, Richard.
My brother, Glenn.
Glenn, welcome.
Hi, Richard.
Brother-in-law, Dale.
How you doing, Richard?
And my youngest brother, Brent.
Hey, Brent. Good to have you. About an hour, maybe half an hour before taping, I ran down. The Robinsons can't do the first show. Why not? Something to do with Dale, they said. I'm going to go down here and find out what it was. You weren't drunk again, were you, Dale?
No, not this time.
Tell us what happened.
Well, it was just a little gem up on the freeway.
Like what?
A few bushes burning on the side of the freeway.
Fire?
Yeah, they call it a brush fire.
Yeah,
but
we've had lots and lots of fires here, but I thought they were all controlled. Now, what freeway were you on?
It was on the 5 and the 10 interchange there. And it was
and
just...
everything blocked?
Well, no, it just slowed them down.
Just
a
Wait
few
a minute.
Weeds
You
burning.
Say 5 and 10? We live there, Gene. Thank you very much. We'll see you here. We've got to go and fight a fire. did you get to the phone to call us? Is that how
I
we
sure
heard
did.
The news? You're a pretty smart cookie. I'm glad you got through.
Didn't
want to
keep you waiting, Richard.
I'm going to give you some raw fish on the way out. Try and get it cooked up as we go through. Come, let's play the feud. One
100 people surveyed. Top six answers on the board. You got to try and get the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name a kind of business whose customers are mostly men. Yeah.
Construction business.
Construction business. No.
Bank.
A bank? No. They say, where are the new game players coming from? Renee.
Richard, I'm going to have to say a barber shop.
Thank you, Renee. Yeah. Barber shop?
We're going to play, Richard.
Both of you go on back.
Okay.
Shame on you. And three cheers for Renee. Standing ovation. Two louts got up there. We're hopeless. Thank you. You were great. Imagine two guys in banks. Everybody uses banks. I shouldn't go on about it. How are you, Glenn?
Pretty good. How you doing?
Can't complain. Kind of business whose customers are mostly men.
How about a health spa or a gym?
All right, let's take that. Gym? No. Well, they have a lot of those. Here's my firefighter.
I'm going to say a tailor.
Taylor's a goodie. Kayla? I shortened you up there. How are you, Brent?
Oh, I'm okay.
Are you sure now? You didn't... I heard a bit of a waver when you said, I'm okay.
Well, I'm just getting over a little sore throat.
What? Get this guy off of here. Well, luckily, I didn't kiss him. Kind of business whose customers are mostly men. Just say it out that way.
A sporting goods store.
Okay, I'll see if it... Sporting goods? You got it. Hey, Grant, a comeback now from the answer construction. Give me a goodie here.
I'm going to say a bar.
A bar. A bar, please. Oh, no. That was a goodie. There was nothing wrong. The other one was silly.
Thank you.
Kind of business whose customers are silly.
What about a massage parlor?
Good answer.
You're a good player, Don. Like, that's got to be there, is it not? Massage? All right. What a weird coupling there. Well, I mean, it is. There are a lot of masseuses and masseurs who have nothing to do with it. At least that's been the way my luck has run. Kind of business customers are mostly men.
Mostly men, huh?
You're a man. Now just think of a business that you go to. You can't?
I'll just say a shoe store.
But they're okay, if not third strike. Shoes! $83.
Gas station. Auto repair shop. Gas station,
Richard. Gas station, yeah, 'cause the women in the world all buy the gas from the men who buy it at the gas station. Well, now everybody uses banks and gas stations. Number four, please.
Sale.
Five. Yeah, all my construction I buy directly from... Come on, big fella. How are you doing today? Have you seen me today? 100 people surveyed. Top six answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something most women find hard to resist. Yes.
Men.
Three answers will beat it, Phil.
Jewelry.
It's there, but you got control. What are you going to do?
We're going to play, Richard.
All right. It was a goodie, Phil. Well done, Renee. Men! What do most women find hard to resist?
How about clothing? Good.
Is that the same as clothing? Very good, Phil. There's never a fire around when you need one, is there? Dale.
Well, from the women I know, I'm going to have to say money.
Money? All right. Money? No. Something most women find it hard to resist.
What about, like, a nice car?
Okay. Sure. A nice car? No, not that. All righty, Grant.
I'm going to say shopping, Richard.
All right. Thus they are okay, if not third strike. To shop or not to shop. Put it there,
thank you.
Number one answer. Very good. Sweet Renee. What would you think?
Richard, how about an evening out to dinner? Uh-huh. No cooking.
Good answer.
Nope. What did you say?
No cooking.
Oh, no. I thought you said no commitment. I did. I thought that's what you said. I did. I thought, what a great answer then. An evening out to dinner, but no commitment. I won't commit you to cook, my honey. If it's there, all right. If not, there's right. Evening out for dinner. Good answer. Oh, you're great. Okay. Come on now. Give it to me.
Well, I think I'll say television.
Please don't encourage him. Is there all right if not? Third. TV? No. $87 up there.
Flattery.
Flattery.
Compliments are flattery.
Your answer?
Flattery.
Flattery. Flattery's thou. We have a very close game. If not a big lead for Grant and the family, flattery. Yeah, champs 87, challengers 83. Let's go. Glenn and Mary Blair. How are you doing today? All right. Now watch this guy. He's a bit of a sleeper here. Here we go. 100 people surveyed. Top 7 answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something that happens every year.
Christmas.
Christmas.
I'm going to play.
Yeah. Hey. Suddenly became very relaxed. He put both his hands in his pocket. She said, we're going to play. Very good. What happens every year, Dale?
Well, every year I know if there's a New Year's Day.
Okay. There's a New Year's Day. There you go.
Your birthday.
Good answer. Good answer.
Thank you. Birthday. Graham?
I'm gonna have to say tax time, Richard.
Yeah. Taxes! Yeah. I'm proud. Now they're all playing like you. You were the sole survivor there for a moment, but now they're all kicking in. What happens every year, Renee?
Thanksgiving.
Oh. Thanksgiving, please. Not there. Still happens every year. Didn't make it. 2 in a row you're going to give me?
The seasons change.
Uh-huh. Yeah. The 7 seasons.
All right.
What happens every year?
How about Easter?
Easter. That's right. Easter? No. Okay. 2 strikes, 2 answers left. What happens every year, Mark?
Well, World Series.
Yeah, good answer.
If it's there, all right, sir. If not, third strike. The World Series.
All right.
Well done. Come on, guys. Boy, oh boy, they're like raisins. One more left.
Well, I'm going to say the Super Bowl, Richard.
Super Bowl.
Good answer, Grant.
Thus they're okay. If not, third strike. Super Bowl? No. Oh. One answer has to be correct.
Wedding anniversary.
Anniversary.
What happens every year?
Anniversary.
An anniversary. If it's there, sir, you get the money, and if not, Grant, you do. Anniversary. You got it? 4th of July, 173, 87, let's go. Oh, you big guy. Dollar values are doubled. Thank you. 100 people surveyed. Top 4 answers on the board. Here is the question. What do you think is the most work-saving household appliance?
Yeah. Dishwasher.
Dishwasher. One answer will beat it.
Clothes dryer.
Clothes dryer.
Got control? What is it?
We'll play.
Well done, huh? Well done. Get to meet my buddy. Haven't seen you for a while. What do you think's the most work-saving household appliance, man?
Well, the clothes washer.
The washer.
Good answer, Mike. Good one.
It beats hitting them with rocks, doesn't it? When I was a boy, that's what... Don't nod your head. That's a joke. Washing machine. Yeah. How are you getting all this time off from your attorney, aren't you?
That's right. They were kind enough to give me the week off, and
really?
when we're on the show, they're going to close down the office, and we're going to watch Family Feud that day.
Just that day, though? Yeah. Well, it's fine. One out of 365. What do you think's the most...
I would say vacuum cleaner myself.
Yeah. Vacuum! What did you say?
How about the good old can opener?
Let's take a look. I know I can get tired opening cans manually. Can opener? No. First try. Mary Jo. The most work-saving household appliance. What do you think it is?
A stove.
Stove, all right.
Good answer.
Is there you got it if not second strike? Stove!
Oh. Yeah.
281, 173, let's go! There you go. Good luck to both of you. Both of you flatten your hands out like good as it. Dollar values are tripled. This is going to decide it. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Tell me a word that's used by a scorekeeper in bowling. Yeah.
Strike.
Strike? You did it. What are you going to do?
We're
going to play. Okay, well done. Listen carefully. Fifth question. I won't repeat it. I'm going to read it once. When I get to you, you have 3 seconds to answer it. Tell me a word that's used by a scorekeeper in bowling.
Pins, Richard.
Pins? No. Renee.
3 seconds.
Alley
ball.
Alley ball? You know what that means. All right. Okay. No.
Spare.
Aha. Spare.
I'm going to go with split.
Good.
Is there okay if not? Third strike. Split! No. Oh. Two answers remain.
Let's go.
I need an answer.
Turkey.
Come on now. You got...
Turkey.
Give me an answer.
Turkey.
That means, I think, three strikes in a row. Turkey's there. 276. You win. Keep your title. If not, you're the new champ. Turkey! I'll never eat turkey again.
Me neither, Richard.
Never like him. Well, you gave it a good frame, but turkey never. There are a million terms in them. We'd never gotten to them. I'll make that $250, and we have nice prizes for you. I'm sorry you didn't win more, but thank you.
Thank you, Richard.
I'm sorry. You're a funny man. Maybe right. Steer clear of the fire. Thank you, man. Go play! Go. I know by now. Bill Jr. and Jeff, one more time right after we watch this. Here we go. One more win. 15 seconds for Jeff, please. Tell me how many minutes you usually spend in the shower.
10.
A candy bar with nuts.
Snickers.
The age a woman's figure is best.
25.
A country that has earthquakes.
United States.
A dangerous insect.
Bee.
All right. How many minutes do you in the shower? 10 minutes. Survey said. Candy ball with nuts. Survey. Age woman figures best. 25, you said. Survey said. Country that has earthquakes. America. Survey said. Dangerous insect. The dreaded knife-throwing bee. Survey said 19. Well done, Jeff. Right back to top.
is Phil Junior. Oh, he always leaves in good shape. All you need, 75 points. 70, you're an attorney now. You know better than that. 75 points, all you need for the money. Please remind everyone the answers Jeff gave us. 20 seconds on the clock. Tell me how many minutes you usually spend in the shower.
15.
A candy bar with nuts.
Snickers.
Try again.
Baby Ruth.
The age a woman's figure is best.
25.
Try again.
30.
A country that has earthquakes.
Venezuela.
A dangerous insect.
Bee.
Try again.
Wasp.
Turn around.
Good answer, Phil. Good answer.
How many minutes do you usually spend in the shower? 10 was the number one answer. You said 15. Almost got my Christmas goose early then, I think. Survey said 28. Candy bar with nuts. Almond Joy, number one. You said old Babe Ruth. Survey said 17.
Good job.
The age your woman's figure is best. 25 was the number one answer. You said
30.
You need 30 points. Survey said 4. Country that has earthquakes. This is the reason I will never go there. Venezuela. Yeah. Italy, number one. Venezuela, the survey said 0. Dangerous insects. Spider, number one. The dreaded black widow variety, I gather. You said a wasp. You need 26 points for the money. Survey said 21. Didn't you do that once before, very close?
We came at 199.
Yeah, 199 one. 195, $5 every point. Total up.
There
975.
You
go. You will retire. We'll get your buddies up here. Young lady from the audience. you're beautiful. They got over almost $14,000. I only wish we had the money to give them. We'll see you here on The Feud. Bye-bye.
Some of the party. This is Gene Wood speaking for Family Feud. By Mark Goodson, television production.
Tonight, John.
It's time for the Family Feud. Introducing the Blair family. Phil Sr., Mary Jo, Jeff, and Mike, ready for action. And the Sambar family. Chuck, Mary, Shaddy, Al, and Todd. On your mark. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
Thank you. The Madison, they're the champs, the Blairs. Boy, you're doing quite well. How much money have we won, Phil?
$13,913.
I like the way you're doing it. You go all the way here. Let's meet everybody, please.
To my right, we have my father, Phil.
Big Phil.
Hi, and Richard. My mother, Mary Jo.
Pretty Mary Jo.
Hi, Richard.
My brother, Jeff.
He's getting taller by the moment.
And last but certainly not least, little Mike.
With a revolving jacket. Hi there, Mike. I'm not sure whether Mike was a pessimist about this trip or not when we brought you in. You only brought two jackets. He's worn it the right way, inside out.
We're running out of ways to wear it.
Exactly, yeah. Channel 27, we thank you. There's a great family here. The television, ABC station that helped bring in these rascals. You're doing good work. Thank you.
Thank you.
They think you've gotten enough money and they'd like to send you back.
That's understandable.
Money. All right. Make them feel at home. Sambar?
Nice to see you. Well, thank you, sir.
Who do you got here, sir?
I have my lovely wife, Mary.
Hello, Mary.
Curly haired brother Shetty.
Hi, Shetty.
Hi, Richard.
My oldest son, Al.
Hello. Good to see you.
And junior son, Todd.
Welcome.
Hi, Richard.
Good to have you here, Todd.
Thank you, sir.
Now, what do you do, sir? What's your job?
I am vice principal at Hoover High School in Glendale, California.
Are you really?
Are they here? No one? Nobody's here.
Pretend you're all here from our competition school, Crescenta Valley. That's where my son's attending.
Oh, really? Yeah. All right, now, just for a second, pretend you're all students from his school. Give him a round of applause. You knew the rivals were here, right?
Good job.
Yeah. That's very nice. I'm going to give you a B plus for that round of applause. You were very good. Now I'm going to give you a B because you didn't laugh. Ready to play?
Absolutely.
Come, we'll play the Feud. Good luck. 100 people surveyed. Top six answers on the board. You got to try and get the most popular answer. Here is the question. Traditionally, when men fight, they punch each other in the nose. Name something women do when they fight.
Tear hair out.
They tear the hair out.
We're gonna play.
If you see a bald-headed woman anywhere, you know she's been in the ring. How you doing?
Fine.
Nice to have you here, my
love.
Thank
you.
What do women do when they fight?
They scratch.
They do. They scratch. Yeah. Why, Shaddy?
How are you?
Fine. What would you think there, Shaddy?
I would say they'd hit each other with their purse.
The old Ruth Buzzy gag from laughing. Boom. Purse time.
How about kick?
A kick?
Oh, yeah.
The women kick? Nothing worse than shaking hands with it. What do women do when they fight, huh?
They bite, Richard.
Do they? I hope they do.
Good answer, Tom.
I hate it when they bite, Richard. Bite! Yeah, you can just roll along here. One more answer, you got all the money. Chuck.
They punch each other.
Do they? Traditionally, like men. For all the money, punch! No, not there. Men punch each other in the nose. What do women do when they fight?
They spit.
Spit. No.
Oh, come on.
Come on, Shaddy,
do it.
Well, I say they'll tear each other's clothes.
Yeah.
In that case, I'll buy two tickets ringside. If it's there, you got it all. If not, third strike. They tear each other's clothes. No. $95 up there.
Slap.
Richard, we're going to go with slap.
Slap. If it's there, you get the money, and if not, Chuck does. Slap. Sixth, please. Green. Yeah, I always like to be attacked by a good hard scream.
With $95,
let's go. How you doing, big girl? Good. 100 people surveyed, top five answers on the board. Here's the question. After a big snowfall, name something from which people clear the snow.
Driveway.
Don't yell at me. Driveway. Number one answer, Phil.
Hey.
Suddenly thought I lost my hearing. Get back there. I can't believe you. He was so polite at the dance last night.
Would you repeat the question?
Yeah, of course I will, darling. I could barely hear it myself. You're yelling driveway in my ear. After a big snowfall, name something from which people clear the snow.
Their roof.
Yeah, roof! Well done, darling. Why don't you two change jackets occasionally?
I said we were going to, but...
Never did you?
No, he's got to grow a little.
Is he?
Yeah.
I've asked for several days about Mike's love letter. He's always denied he had one. The truth will out. The moment you get a big snowfall, you usually hear the truth. If he doesn't want to tell me, I don't want to hear it from you.
Okay.
Who is it? In my ear. Got you, say no more. I will not mention anything. But Karen, are you doing anything? Are you doing anything this evening, Karen? You have very good taste. After a big snowfall.
Well, in Wisconsin, we clear it from the cars.
You do?
Yep.
All right. The cars. Well done. Get a lot of smell there. Yeah. Why don't you ask her yourself? Just say to her, this Karen. Karen Siderman, a young lady, works up here and writes down whatever words that we get that get strikes. Show a card, my darling. See, and Karen holds it up. Either family can see what's already been said. It seems young Michael has fallen head over snowfall. And, of course, Karen's a blushing. In search of older women. Ask her. Well, just by a couple of years. Ask her whatever you like. What would you like to ask her?
Nothing.
We'll get back to you, honey. Okay. He's a bit shy. Big snowfall. What do people want?
Sidewalk.
Nothing ever bothers you, does it? Never blush?
Not much.
You don't. You're as cool as Cupid. Sidewalk! Yeah! Take it over, mull it over. You're a wealthy man now. Never share the money alone. You can get a condo here. Come to the shows here every day. Just discussing the tourist attractions in Southern California. After the big snowfall, something which people clear snow.
Well, in Madison, we've got these crews that clear all that snow from the streets.
Yeah, good answer.
Sounds like a good job. Streets! Yeah! All money. Come here. Mike and I have got a couple things to talk about, so you watch this commercial, and we'll be back momentarily. Karen, stand up. Now, this is Michael. Shake hands.
Pretty.
Oh, get out of here. What a game. 91, 95. Let's go. Right. 100 people surveyed. Top six answers on the board. Here is the question. Real or fictional? Name a famous Willie.
You'll be served. Yeah.
Willie Loman?
Willie Loman, death of a salesman. No?
That was a goodie.
Willie the Pooh?
Take a look. What? Willie the Pooh. Hold it. Yep.
How about Willie Shoemaker?
Ah, the great jockey, Willie Shoemaker. Okay. Out, two answers. We'll beat it.
Willy Wonka.
Oh.
All right.
Willy Wonka. Yeah, it's there, but you have control. What is it?
Hey.
What are you going to do?
Let's play.
All right, I guess we're going to
play. Remember, though, Willie the Pooh.
Been
all right. Off you go. Back there. Oh. I love that answer. Well, let's get serious. Real or fictional? Famous Karen. Willie.
Willie Shakespeare.
Good answer.
probably knew him very well.
Hey, Willie, what's shaking, baby?
William Shakespeare.
Close enough.
Willie Shakespeare. Be or not to be. That's what we gotta lay down here.
What would you say, real or fictional, famous Willie?
We'll switch gears a little. We'll say Willie Mays.
Yeah. Ah. Yeah. Bam, Willie Mays. Yeah.
That's the way to do it, bro.
Big Phil.
Willie Sutton.
Willie Sutton.
One of the great guys had on my account for years.
Willie Sutton.
Not there. First time he's not been on a list for quite a while. That's done. Real or fictional, famous Willie.
Oh.
Say,
Schmidt.
Can you say, pardon?
I don't know. Willie Schmidt.
Certainly didn't bring you in from Madison for that kind of language, I can assure you.
Willie Schmidt. Oh, I don't know. Not that. One, two, three answers. Like the money, give me one.
Look at this. There's a silent film returning.
Well?
How about Willie Rogers?
Willie Rogers. I will demand to see ID before I go on with this game. Willie Rogers is there. You get the money, and if not, you will.
Willie Rogers! No.
On the road again?
Four!
Willie!
Oh, five! Wee Willie Winky.
Who, strangely enough, a lot of people don't know, was engaged to Willie the Pooh.
138, 95, let's go!
People surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a country known for really spicy food.
Yeah. Mexico.
Mexico. Yeah.
You're going to play, Richard.
Well done, young man. Very proud of you. How you doing?
Fine.
Country known for really spicy food.
Italy.
Oh. Hey, Italia. Phil Jr., what would you say, sir?
Well, I like Euro sandwiches, so I'll say Greece.
Okay.
Greece.
No. I'm worried about
him. Akin to Mexico, how about Spain?
Uh-huh. Barcelona, Spain. Yeah. There you go.
I'm on a real roll here with Willie Smith.
You have played this game. This is about your sixth day. You've played extremely well. You're allowed to have a Willie Smith occasion.
All right. Would France?
Just take a look.
Let's
go. If it's there, you keep your title, and if not, second strike. France? No. Jeff?
Portugal.
Okay. It's better to say no country at all.
True. I guess so.
Not a lot.
Portugal.
No. 194. The game will continue if you give me the correct answer.
China.
Richard.
Country known for really spicy food.
We're going with Chinese.
China.
All right, China.
China's up there. You get the 194. If not, you'll play for the big money. China, is there anyone? China. Four. Well, I'll tell you what. I got a great plan. I'm
yes,
going to give you
$250. Thank
and you.
You
get nice prizes. And you leave the country the day of the show. Otherwise, you'll never live down, Willie.
Thank you.
I'm sorry you didn't mean that. That's a funny answer. Nice to see you. Take care, Jen.
Go play. Go.
The old same old shows. You have to build, going for the money right after we watch that. 15 seconds, please. Name the crime you think most people are arrested for.
Speeding.
How many good dresses a woman owns?
Two.
A department in supermarkets.
Clothes.
A popular color for uniforms.
Green.
A fruit that bruises easily.
Apple.
Turn around. Crime you think most people are arrested for? Speeding.
I was on the 10 most wanted list at one time.
Service.
16. How many good dresses a woman owns?
Two.
Survey said.
30.
Problem in supermarkets. Clothes. I get most of my stuff there. That's why I'm called speeding. I don't want anyone to see me do it.
Survey said.
Pop your color for uniforms.
Green.
Survey said. 11. Fruit that bruises easily.
Apple.
Survey said. 6. First time you've not gone over 100. I say it's about time you let Phil Jr. do the work. And here he is. Phil, this time you got to get over 100 right now. Please remind everyone the answer Jeff gave us. When you've stopped laughing, give us 20 seconds on the clock, please. Name the crime you think most people are arrested for.
Drunk driving.
How many good dresses a woman owns?
4.
A department in supermarkets.
Bakery.
A popular color for uniforms.
Blue.
A fruit that bruises easily.
Banana.
Turn around. Crime most people are arrested for? You said what? Drunk driving? Everybody said. 31. Number one answer was shoplifting or burglary. Of course, you're an attorney. You wouldn't know that. How many good dresses a woman owns? 2. Number one answer, you said 4. Survey said? 6. Apartment in supermarket. You said bakery. Survey said? 0. Fruit and vegetables tied at the top. Popular color of uniforms. You gave me blue, blue and white. They were tied. Survey said? 42. Fruit that bruises easily, a Georgia peach. Number one, you said banana. Survey said?
Two.
182. $5.2. Love. There's another 9.
Oh, all right. Hi. See you here on the Feud. Bye-bye.
Some departing contestants receive from the Blair family. Phil Sr., Mary Jo, Jeff and Mike, ready for action. And the Sally family. Everett, Marilyn, Libby, Lisa, and Cass, on your marks. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
The Madison, the Champs, the Blairs.
Yeah, yeah.
Day 6 of the hostages. How much money you want?
$15,155, Richard. We're very happy.
Let's meet everybody, please, Phil.
Over on our last show. He confessed to me that, actually, he didn't confess. His brother told me that he liked this pretty young lady, Miss Karen Siderman, who works with us, just a couple of months older than... if you'd like to take her out for dinner or drink or go away for the weekend, Palm Springs. what's your answer?
Elmo.
All right, I think we'll leave it at that. We brought these rascals in from Tulsa, make them feel at home. The Sally's here.
How are you doing? How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
Fine. I want to meet everybody, please.
Okay, I got my wife, Marilyn.
Hi, Richard.
Hi, my darling.
My mother-in-law, Libby.
Sweet Libby.
How do you do?
My daughter, Lisa.
Hi, Richard.
Hi, Lisa.
And my son, Cass.
Cass, good. You're looking good.
Thank you.
What's the name of the station that you watch Family Feud on?
Channel 8, KTUL.
I was just checking.
Eight's the place. Eight's the place. All right, yeah.
Eight's the place.
Eight's the place.
That's it.
I'm going to wear this. Well, they're good people. The only thing is they make bumper stickers you can't peel. There we go.
There it is. That's it.
There you go.
Wait a minute. I better put the eight there.
There. There it is. That's good.
And you tell 27 to send me one of these immediately, we'll and I'll wear 27s for pride.
Lisa's got a little present for you.
Lisa's got a present for me?
He's
just a good old boy. He's on the road again.
He is. How are you, sweetie?
Hey, sweetie, you're a sweetie.
Listen, I am president of the American Junior Quarter Association, which is the largest equine association in the United States. And this is our grand champion trophy. So our grand champion trophy we'd like to give to you because you're a grand champion host.
Oh, good. Good. Thank you. Can you please thank everybody involved?
I sure will.
Come, we'll play the field. Now, you're obviously a drinking boy. I just want one hand up there, Everett.
Okay.
God bless you. Thank you, sir. 100 people surveyed. Top 6 answers on the board. You got to try and find the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name something you drink for reasons other than thirst. On the road again.
Yes. Medicine.
What sort of medicine?
Kaopectate.
You wouldn't be able to go on the road again a lot, would you? Kale Pectate. No, not there. Phil?
How about cough syrup?
Cough syrup? Play a pass.
We're going to pass, Richard.
All right. The first time they've ever done this. Come on back here. We're going to sachet on and Kale Pectate.
That Everett really comes up with some good ones.
He surely does, honey. All right, what do you drink for reasons other than thirst, Marilyn?
How about Alka-Seltzer?
Right, a little Alka. You've got it. How are you, Liv?
Hi.
How are you doing?
What, do you have to be thirsty to have a drink of booze?
Not at all, as far as I'm concerned. If you want a slug, take one.
Well, that's the way
Boom.
I feel.
Number one answer. Well done, honey.
If you drink for caffeine, coffee, to all stay
right.
awake.
Okay, doll. All right.
Okay.
Coffee. Yeah.
Hey, dude.
Oh, you're pretty neat here.
Yes, sir.
Very stylish. What would you say, Cass?
Well, if you got coffee, what about tea?
Why not, sir? Is there any all tea right. there? Yes. Not there. First try. Right. Ever. Right. Name something you drink for reasons other than thirst.
Milk for ulcers.
Sorry, milk? Name something you drink.
Orange juice.
All right, let's take a look.
Yes, Mom.
They got it all, if not second try. OJ. We're on the road again. We're going to be back right after this. Here you are. Big 100 people surveyed. Top 5 answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something kids sometimes swap with other kids.
Yeah. Marbles.
Marbles. One answer will beat it.
Cars. The little toy cars.
Cars.
Toys. We have toys.
Oh. Okay.
Oh, I'm sorry about that. Yo-yos.
Give you 3 more seconds. Well, give me an answer.
Well, everything kids have are toys.
See, she's all quite right. stubborn about that.
Yes, I am.
All right.
Go play a pen.
We're going to
go play.
Play! Okay.
Shooter. Go on back to your room.
What are the kids... Oh, I didn't say hello to you.
Hello, Richard.
What do kids sometimes swap with other kids?
Trading cards.
Yeah.
Good answer.
Cards!
What do you say?
Only thing I can think of is bicycles.
They swap bicycles?
Bicycles?
No. Well, here's my buddy. How you doing?
Fine.
Something kids sometimes swap with other kids.
Jewelry?
What the hell's going on here? Jewelry? Who ever let me see you swap any of your jewelry with this? Not unless you get a good deal.
Jewelry! No! Bill! I can remember trading articles in my lunch at school.
Yeah. Oh, food. Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, I like that. Like a peanut butter and jelly for something you didn't particularly like.
Right.
Right. Frog sandwich.
Food!
Yeah.
Well, Richard, I'm going to go with sports equipment.
Okay, good. Good answer.
Sports? No. $91 up there. Everett, come on down.
What do you say, sir?
They said comic books.
What do you say?
Comic books.
Fair enough. Comic books should take a big lead, if not a very even game. Comic books! On the floor! Oh, I know, Michael. Nudity, I don't mind. It's the jewelry I'm against. We'll be back right after this. People survey, top 8 answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a nationwide hotel motel chain.
Marriott. Oh. No one's ever done that. We've had a lot of people yell out, but we have never had anyone yell out, frighten the other person, then buzz in. Honey, I jumped with you. Well, we'll see. You won't lose because...
It isn't even number one.
It isn't?
No.
Well, let's take a look. You're so casual about it, honey. Marriott! Not that. Mary Jo, nationwide hotel motel chain.
Hilton?
The Hilton. There you go. Are you going to play a pair?
Yes, they want to play.
Okay.
Thanks. You're a beauty. You're a beauty. You make me laugh, Liv. Never had anybody do that since we've been on the air.
Marriott! Nationwide Hotel Motel Chain, yeah.
How about Howard Johnson?
All right. Let's take a look. Howard! You got it? You hear that, Mike?
Holiday Inn.
You got it. The Holiday Inn. Oh, ho. Bill?
Roadstar 8.
Pardon?
Roadstar 8.
I just invented it. Roadstar 8. No.
They have them in Wisconsin.
Oh, sure. Well, I'm sure they're fine. Just they don't spend a lot on advertising, obviously. Nationwide hotel motel chain.
Travelodge. Travelodge, is it there? You got it. Pretty Mary Jo?
Best Western.
Best Western, all right. BW, Best Western. You got it. Yes.
How about the Sheraton?
Okay. Oh,
we're looking for the Sheraton. Who answers left? Just for them here, Mike.
Hyatt.
Yeah. This kid knows a lot of, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
Hyatt! No!
What would you say, Phil, after that excellent one you gave me the last time around?
I'm going to come up with one just as good, probably.
Nationwide Hotel Motel chain. Got 3 seconds, man.
Budget six.
I'm drawing a blank.
Do you make these up? Yeah. Is there a budget?
Well, these are for real.
They are for real. Budget six. No. $87 there.
Well,
Everett.
Ramada in.
The Ramada. If you say you get the money, if not, they'll Ramada. Number six. Motel six. $274. Nothing. Let's go. You got the six right, Phil.
Dollar values are double. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something that can be lumpy.
Yeah.
A bed.
A bed. Three answers will beat it.
Dough.
Nope. You got control.
Well play, Richard.
Okay. We're going to play. Well done, Jeff. What can be lumpy, Mike? Three seconds. Okay. Don't worry. First time you've not given me an answer since you've been on the air. What do you say?
Sugar.
Sugar.
No, it's the Ramadama 6 is very lumpy sugar. Something that can be lumpy, Phil.
Gravy.
Oh, good answer.
Gravy for Phil. You got it, champ. Pretty merry go.
What's going to be lumpy?
Potatoes.
Aha. Is there all right if not third strike? Potato. You got it. One more. Finish this up. What is it going to be, champ? Something can be lumpy.
Isn't a pillow lumpy sometimes?
Let's take a look.
Good answer.
Pillows there, you got it. If not, third strike. Pillow. Nope. You're going to be the champs if you give me the number one answer. Give me an answer.
Dumplings.
Dumplings. Just there, you play for it. If not, you will have lived a charmed life. The dreaded lumpy dumpling. No, you're in the game. Thank you. All right, come on, let's go.
Oh, good luck, guys.
Both of you, flatten your hands out like good boys. Dollar values are tripled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a place where people sit on benches.
Baseball game.
Baseball game. Yeah. One answer will beat it.
The park.
Mike says the park. Yeah. Player nice, pass. Nice.
We'll play.
We'll play. Listen carefully. Fifth question. I'll read it once. Be quiet. I'm not going to repeat it. You get 3 seconds when I get to you. Not a toughie. Name a place where people sit on benches.
Church.
Church.
Football field.
Long ball games. Oh, 3 seconds.
I'm sorry.
It's all right. There you go.
Cafeteria.
Okay.
Good answer.
Keep your title. Cafeteria. Jeff, 3 seconds.
How about...
Chance way to get the title. One... What do you say?
Bus station.
If it's there, you play for the big money. If not, you keep your title one more time. A bus station? $110 to $15,155.
Thank you, Richard.
It was a pleasure. I pray for families like you.
You're
gorgeous. Love my birds.
You're wonderful.
Your kids are great. You're a nice young man. Yeah. Hope you had a good time. Yeah. Wait a minute. Wait. Who's going to play? Go. They're going with the money right after we watch. Name an animal people dress up as for Halloween parties.
A pig.
Don't start the clock yet, just a second.
No, it's fine.
That was just awful.
Here we go. Listen. Here we go. Something you buy in parks.
Candy.
Something found in child. Something found in a child's school bag.
Books.
A kind of leg people eat.
Beg your pardon?
A kind of leg people eat.
Leg? Chicken leg.
Another word meaning rapid.
Fast.
Something you're not. Turn
That's
around.
Right. Come here.
My family's gonna disown me.
No. No, they won't disown you, honey, but in that particular part of our game, you cannot say, what? And I say, leg, and you say, leg. I know. The animal people dress up.
This is great.
Halloween.
It's terrible. Terrible.
Pig, he said. Survey said? No. Something you buy in parks, candy, you said? And then you sort of hung on the word candy. Yeah, yeah. I thought something else was coming out, like candy cane or...
Cotton candy.
Survey said? Four.
Oh, well, right.
Something found in a child's school bag. You said book? Survey said...
All right, now.
Kind of like the people eat. You said what? Kind of like the leg chicken. Survey said? All right. No, the word meaning rabbit. You said files. Survey said? There.
Oh!
Run on back there. Look at Melissa. Molly shot.
Thank you.
Mange, all you need. 77 points, you got the money. Please remind everyone the answer Marlon gave us 20 seconds on the clock. Name an animal people dress up as for Halloween parties.
Lion.
Something you buy in parks.
Cotton candy.
Try again.
Hot dogs.
Something found in a child's school bag.
Pencils.
A kind of leg that people eat.
Chicken.
Try again.
Frog.
Another word meaning rapid.
Fast.
Try again.
Speed.
Yeah, what did you say?
Speed.
Speed. On the road again.
Good. No, don't go?
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah, sure. Animal people dress up for Halloween. Cat was number one. You said a lion. Survey said... Five. Something you buy in parks. Peanuts, number one. You said hot dogs. Survey said 20. Something found in child's school bag. You said pizza.
Mm-hmm.
Number one answer.
Oh,
survey said
thank you.
41. Kind of leg that people eat. A leg of lamb was number one. You said a frog's leg. It was worth 11 points. You got $5,000. Survey said
yes.
We'll be back right now.